into modular probably around 2013, 14. I'm friends with Richard X, who was into modular already. And I was trying to solve a MIDI timing issue in my studio. And he said, oh, well, there's this modular set of modules that are much slicker because it avoids MIDI altogether. It avoids old school MIDI altogether. And that was the Expert Sleepers Silent Way stuff. And in order to give that a go, I had to buy like a little case so I could put these modules in, and then sort of also have the little case. And I thought, oh, I might just try a filter. So I bought this filter, which I could then have with the ARP as a second filter. And then, as everyone says, you know, the first taste is free or whatever, and then it's slippery slope. The first one was Panorama Bar, which is kind of what energized me into getting it going, because I'd had this idea to take a modular with me. And then I got this offer from Panorama Bar. I was like, okay, this is when I'm going to do it. At the very beginning, it was a very cautious like integration of it. So I'm still using Ableton. I've got everything in Ableton as WAVs. If the modular fell over and turned off, I could carry on playing. It was just sort of playing along. As I kind of got used to it, then I would make the modular do more and more and the computer do less and less. But generally Ableton's doing the drums, all the drums. The modular is playing sequences, sort of baseline sequences and that kind of stuff on top, and effects and processing audio coming through it. It's not a typical modular synth experience where it's sort of generative patches evolving over time and you bring a picnic kind of thing. It's more like, how can I make all this stuff work? Just about scraping a couple of tracks now where it's just the modular. So it's an evolution, really. Saturday's show, which is in 2 days' time, will be the first one where there's no Ableton for like sections of it. Those will be either the moments where it's time to go to the bar or like the best moment. The tracks that I'm sort of playing the most live, when I play live, aren't really recorded tracks. They're kind of sort of things that I've just put together for the show. I think it's kind of important that the synth is facing the audience. It's like I don't have it tucked away and like I'm just working on it and you don't need to see what I'm doing kind of thing. It's more like, here it is. It's kind of running. It's like it's almost got a personality. I don't have to do too much to it. It's all prepared. So it's a sort of a bit of a spectacle. It's a small spectacle. It's sort of in a club, I feel it sort of makes a nice kind of difference and a bit of a statement. So this is the case that I take out sort of my shows regularly. And then this whole thing is basically my studio rig, and taking the whole thing to the show on Saturday. Normally, I've only got one oscillator, which is here, and a way to get lots of different sounds out of one oscillator is to route it in different ways. So maybe route it through a wave folder, maybe don't route it through a wave folder. And a way to do that without having to patch lots of cables, change cables between songs or change cables within a song, is to have a kind of a router module. So this is a mechanical switch, or a series of mechanical switches. So behind there's no real electronics, it's just like a great big, I've got a thing, it's a bit like this, but it's got lots of discs on it. And so it's got loads of different settings. So this oscillator, like basically on its own with no control or anything coming into it, sounds kind of like this. It's actually getting a repeating envelope, but nothing's happening. Ableton's not running. This is just this oscillator being driven by a repeating envelope, but it goes so fast that it's like metallic. And that's just on a setting where nothing, on this setting here of the switch, nothing is driving any gates or anything. Can use the same oscillator and send it something from Ableton. So I'll trigger an Ableton clip. So that's CV gate coming from here, driving this top part of the envelope. this modulation sequencer is also changing step with every note. So it's getting, instead of getting a clock, it's getting a copy of the gate that's driving this. So this oscillator is doing a sine wave, which is going through this wave folder. So this is a nice sort of, it's kind of alternative to like a resonant filter. It's getting modulation from here. So if you put all these to zero, you get just a very static sound. But with a bunch of sort of different settings, it's gonna basically automate this knob for you. And then I can trigger some audio drums from Ableton. Should start now. And then these knobs are basically MIDI controls. So this is sending out to Ableton, just not that mistake. So I can do like high pass filtering stuff on the audio. And reverbs and delays, which are all happening in Ableton on just on the audio. So this, the modular stuff's unaffected by that. And this switch is essentially just another MIDI controller switch. So I've got this assigned to like a machine gun fill, which is kind of fun and never really gets old in my opinion. So that's a sequence coming from Ableton. And then there are sort of more modular ways of generating the sequence, one of which I've prepared here. So that is the same envelope, because it's all coming through and being routed here, but a different oscillator, which is a digital oscillator down here, with FM VDO, which is a, I think it's a wavetable. But so it's got all these waveforms, and you can use this same modulation to switch between the waveforms, which sort of gives it that the variation in the quality of the sound. Quite a simple sound to quite gnarly. Now this envelope down here is just on a repeat mode, so it's not getting triggered by anything except itself. But that's really nice for like, this is where, same sound as that, but just with a different envelope. It's good for sort of effects like this. This is set to be a delay here. And it's nice that you can switch between sounds quite quickly and easily. Like this. So you can sort of do chaos to resolution, which is a lovely thing, I think. Hey, I'm Rex the Dog, and this is How I Play Live.